Hi students, welcome to online class. In this video, we are going to discuss about chapter 9, Introduction to C++. We are going to discuss about expression. What is mean by expression and then what are the types of expressions? See, an expression is a combination of operators, constants and variables. It may be arranged as per the rules of C++. See, we already studied about operators and operands. Operators are used to perform some operation. Operand is an entity that acts on operator. Operand is an entity that acts on operator. Operator is used to perform the operation. Now we are going to discuss about expression. What is mean by expression? See, the expression means it is the combination of operator, variables, and then it may contains constants. So the expression will be followed as per the rules which are defined in C++. Sometimes the expression may also include the function calls which return the values. So later we can discuss about the function calls and how to return the values. See, an expression may contain one or more operands and zero or more operators to produce a value. An expression is a, it may contain one or more operands and zero or more operators to produce a value. Now let us see the different types of expressions. What are the different types of expressions? Constant expression, then integer expression, then floating expression, that is floating point expression, then relational expression, logical expression, bitwise expression, and then last one is pointer expression. Can you understand, students? Totally there are 7 different types of expressions are there. What are they? Constant expression, integer expression, floating point expression, then relational expression, logical expression, bitwise expression, and then pointer expression. Now we can see all the expressions in a detailed manner. Can you understand, students? Now we are going to see about constant expression. Constant expression consists of only constant values. Whenever a constant value is assigned to the variable, then that expression can be called as a constant expression. It does not change its value. So see here, in this example, int num is equal to 100. So here I have assigned the value 100 for the variable num. This expression can be called as constant expression if I does not change the value for the variable. Now we are going to see the integer expression. What is mean by integer expression? Whenever the combination of integer values with variables and arithmetic operators are used, then it produces integer results. Whenever the integer values and we are using the arithmetic operators and some variables with the arithmetic operators to produce the integer results. So this type of expressions is called integer expression. Now you see here, sum is equal to num1 plus num2. So here num1, num2 and sum, all these are variables. And then num1 is added with num2. So here arithmetic operator is used. And then num1, num2, both the variables are integer variables. So it will contain the integer values. So the result will be stored in sum. So sum is also a integer variable. Can you understand, students? Integer expression means which contains the integer values, and then it will contain some variables. That variables will be performed with some operator, that is simple arithmetic operators, to produce the integer results. Now we are going to see the float expression. What is mean by float expression? The combination of floating point values are used with variables with simple arithmetic operators, then they produce the floating point results. Can you understand, students? Whenever the floating point values are added with floating point values are added with some variables. Added means when floating point values are combined with, we are using the floating point variables. Then we are using some simple arithmetic operators to produce the floating point results. Then this type of expression is called float expression. Now you see area is equal to 3.14 into r into r. Here 3.14 is a floating point value, and then r into r, so both of them are radius. Sometimes the radius value may be a floating point value, so we get the result as floating point value that is stored in the variable area. Can you understand, students? Now we are going to see the relational expression. What is mean by relational expressions? Relational expression means whatever the variable we are using, whatever the value we are using, that is not a problem. Whenever we are using the relational operators in an expression, then that expression is called relational expression. Whenever we are using the relational operators in an expression, then it is called as a relational expression. So we are using the variables, and then we are going to use the relational operators. Whenever we use the relational operators, we get the result as Boolean value, that is true or false. True means the result is 1. False means the result is 0. Can you understand, students? Whenever we are using the relational operators with the variables, we get the Boolean value, that is 1 or 0. Then that is called relational expression. Now we are going to see about logical expression. The combination of values and variables are used with logical operators. Whenever the logical operators are combined with the variables and values, then they are called as logical expression. It is also used to produce the Boolean result. It is also used to produce the Boolean result, that is 1 or 0, that is true or false. Now in these examples you can see the relational operator greater than is used. Like that, here also a plus b is equal to c plus d. So here in the above example, relational operators are used, so the expression is called relational expression. Like that, here you can see the logical operator AND is used, so this expression is called logical expression. Then we can see about the bitwise expression. What is mean by bitwise expression? Whenever we use the bitwise operators with some variables and values, then that expression is called bitwise expression. Whenever we combine the variables and values with bitwise operator, then that is called bitwise expression. Now you can see here the symbol shift left and shift right. Shift left and shift right operators are used in this example. So this expression is called bitwise expression. Then last expression is pointer expression. What is mean by pointer expression? Whenever a pointer variable is used, whenever a pointer variable is declared, and then whenever we are using the pointer variable in a statement, then that expression is called pointer expression. First of all, before going for the pointer expression, you want to know about what is mean by pointer variable. Pointer variable means which is used to hold the memory address of another variable. Pointer variable means which is used to store the address of another variable. Pointer variable is declared by using the symbol asterisk. Pointer variable is declared by using the symbol asterisk. Now in this example, you can understand that int asterisk ptr. Int asterisk ptr. What is mean by int asterisk ptr means ptr represents the pointer variable. And then we have initialized the value a is equal to 4, that is of integer data type. Now I am assigning the value 4 to the pointer variable. I am assigning the address of a to the pointer variable ptr. So this expression is called as pointer expression. Can you understand, students? Pointer variable is a variable that is used to hold the address of another variable. It is not like ordinary variable. It is always used to hold the address of another variable. It is declared by using the symbol asterisk. So that variable is called as pointer variable. The other variables are called ordinary variables. I think you might have understood this video. So let's end the class. So thank you, students.